The Volvo 240 is known for many things: durability, longevity, a heater that rivals Nebuchadnezzar's furnace, and being undeniably cool. One thing that it is not known for is power, and in the world of budget bolt-ons, camshafts will come pretty high on the list. Hi, you are a mechanically minded individual. You know what a camshaft is, you know what it does, and how to install it. Or at least, you are confident in your abilities to type words into your search engine of choice to yield the results necessary to complete the task at hand. You are here because you want to know which camshaft is right for your 240. Here's how I can help. I have done countless seconds, even minutes, of research to compile this information and present it to you in a meaningful way. So please, glean from my experience and Googling prowess. Originally, Volvo 240s came with the B cam, which offered a standard lift and duration for the daily driver. However, around 1981, Volvo swapped out the B cam for the M cam in the United States in order to minimize emissions. This is probably what your Volvo has. Around 3,000 RPMs, you'll notice that the gas pedal essentially becomes a volume knob. You'll stomp on it on the freeway, the car will get loud, but it won't move forward in any meaningful way. The M cam is undesirable for the Volvo enthusiast. And as I understand it, just about any camshaft will yield a desirable upgrade in power band. But if you're gonna go through the trouble of swapping out camshafts in your 240, you might as well do it right. So, which one is correct for you? I'm dividing these up into four categories: your naturally aspirated automatic Volvo 240s, your manual NAs, your automatic turbos, if they exist, and your manual turbos. Automatic transmissions will not give you any control over shift timing. Therefore, you'll want a camshaft that yields a little bit better power at the lower end. The naturally aspirated engine will not give you that turbo boost at higher RPMs anyway. My recommendation is that you look for the B cam, the K cam, or the IPD VX camshaft if you feel like spending the money. Obviously, if you're going to go this route, make sure and get the camshaft designed for non-turbo engines. Your manual gearbox does allow for control over RPMs, and with a manual, you're generally going to have a more aggressive drive than without. For this, go with your A cam or the H cam. And of course, you can still pick up the VX non-turbo camshaft for these. One other thing to mention, if you are planning to tow or otherwise turn your brick into a tractor, go with the T cam. This will give you more low-end torque, among other things. The automatic turbo seems to be something of a rarity these days, a jack of all trades, master of none type situation. However, the research I've done has yielded some specificity on this, as you would probably T5 swap your turbo anyway. For this, look for the A cam. Owners of the automatic turbos have reported that they prefer this to all others. Of course, you can still go with the IPD VX turbo cam if you can't find the A cam. Now, a manual 240 has the potential to be the most fun out of all of these. If you own this, look for the H cam, the K cam, or go ahead and pop for the VX turbo cam. In closing, before you start this project, make sure you understand shimming your lifters, consider an adjustable timing gear to move the power band where you want it, and remember that just about any camshaft is going to do better than the M cam that is probably under your hood now. When you do this, paint your valve cover, and always remember to replace your gaskets. Thanks for watching. Let me know if you have any questions.